Conscious Spirit Media.
Hi there, it's Gabriel here, and this is Conscious Spirit Media, and I'm really, really excited to be introducing Maria here. She's a past life regression, she does quantum healing, hypnosis, and some Reiki healing as well. So some amazing wisdom and knowledge. And I just had a quick session with her for channeling and feeling into my energy and just learning more about who I am. And it was absolutely amazing. Just like intuitively I knew it was right, and just like she's really accurate at the reading. So I highly recommend it. If you do get a chance to do a reading with her, go for it, okay? So yeah, I'd like to introduce Maria and tell me, Maria, about more about how you got into this and everything.
Okay, first of all, hello everybody, nice to see you today. I hope your day is going really, really well. So it started about 7 years ago when I started having a very strong intuitive sensation that I need to go towards spirituality. It started somewhere here. I can't even describe it, I can't explain. The events in my life speeded up, there was some magic happening, and I felt really drawn to look for intuition or extrasensory perception. And I started looking for groups or courses or classes, and I found a lady called Dolores Cannon, and that was the biggest discovery in my life, and I'm very blessed to have discovered her. So she was a hypnotherapist from the States who developed a technique called quantum healing hypnosis. And the first time I heard Dolores' interview, it felt like incredible. It felt like my consciousness expanded several times, like I grew, my spirit grew, and I remembered everything that I needed to remember. Wow. Because she spoke about other life forms, about life after death, about the other side, about the spirit guides, about this big, big, big power that exists all around us and has all the knowledge in the universe. It's like the higher self, the higher consciousness, and we have the ability to connect to this power. We have the ability to channel the messages. So when I heard Dolores, I just knew I had to follow this track, and I did the course, so I learned how to do this work. And at the same time, I learned Reiki. I was blessed to find a beautiful teacher called Miguel, and I was beautifully introduced into this. And since then, it's been my journey.
So yeah, we'll get into Reiki, learn more about what that is. We'll get into some quantum healing, hypnosis, what that is, and more into a past life regression, because that's really, really fascinating. So let's start with Reiki and tell me a bit more about what it is and the benefits that people can realize.
Reiki is beautiful. That's all I can say. Reiki is pure. You don't have to understand Reiki, you just have to feel it. And to be honest with you, every human being, we have wonderful healing energy. Every person, even every animal, every plant, we already have the ability to feel energy. Even if you take your hands next to each other and you connect.
I feel it, yeah.
And you spend a bit of moment with your hands and you take a deep breath. And you allow the energy to pass through your hands. And play with it a little bit. Very soon you'll start to feel the flow. And if somebody else gives you energy, you can also pick that up. You can feel the connection. So it's very, very simple. Well, Reiki takes it a little bit to another level. So when you learn Reiki, you're being attuned to the energy of Reiki. It's like a life force energy. It is a pure energy of love. That's how I see it. And you learn to channel it through your hands and give it to yourself or to the other person. You can even give it to animals, you can give it to plants, you can give it to life situations. And it's a healing energy. Reiki relaxes the body, Reiki relaxes the spirit. It lets go of negative emotions or anything that, you know, needs to leave the body at this moment. It's a very pure form, very safe, and you can never have too much of Reiki, so Reiki is always good for you. So Reiki is very popular now. Many, many people practice, even in hospitals. I think now Reiki, in some of the hospitals, it's allowed to practice Reiki. So I always encourage people to try that.
Fantastic. So Reiki is really about the energy healing that Maria was talking about. Let's get more into maybe a similar topic, the quantum healing hypnosis. Tell us a bit more about that.
Okay. That's a really profound topic. That's actually even a bigger topic that we can discover. So it's a technique, it's a type of a session. When the person comes for a session and they have some questions, for example, they want to know what their purpose is in life, or maybe they want to heal something in their body, maybe they want to know about their relationships. So it touches upon many different subjects. And quantum healing consists of two main components. The first one is a past life regression. So we go to a very deep state with the help of the voice, very calm voice, special words that allow the person to reach that space between sleep and awakening. You know this feeling when you just woke up in the morning and you still remember the dream and you're still in between the worlds, and sometimes you can connect and see a symbol or have a memory or have some recognition inside. So we're using that state. And then it happens that the person, through this technique, goes to a past life. So the person sees themselves in another body, in another place somewhere, and we start discovering what is the story. So for example, it can be anything. It can be Victorian times, Stone Age, medieval times. It can be human, it can be animals, it can be plants. There are so many things we can be, because the spirit is forever. The soul is forever. It never dies. Mm. It can never be destroyed. It just changes shape, changes form, travels from one place to another, learning lessons. So they say that Earth is a school that we need to graduate from. So we come here and we plan certain things that we want to learn together. And we find spirits that we want to come with. For example, our parents, our partners in life, our friends. So people who are important in our life, people whom we recognize on the spirit level. You know the feeling that you meet a person and you have a very strong connection and you don't know why. The connection is in the eyes. So always pay attention to the intuitive feeling. Probably you've met that person before. So coming back to past life regression, you can discover not just who you were in a past life, because we had many different past lives, hundreds, some people thousands of past lives, but also what message does it have for your current life? Because every past life has a message. So the subconscious of the person chooses a particular story, a particular past life, which has some sort of a meaning. For example, let's say somebody has achieved a lot in a past life. Somebody was successful, a successful writer, a successful creator of some kind. And maybe in this life, this person is doubting themselves. Maybe they don't have enough power, they think. So the subconscious may show them a past life of a big success, so they can remember how big and powerful they are. Next, for example, if in a past life the person had a trauma of some kind, maybe they had a difficult death in a past life, maybe there was something that happened to them, traumatic, and they didn't have the chance to let it go, and they may have a bit of remnant of it in this life. So this is where the physical healing comes. So some people have a physical pain of unexplained origin. And if it comes from the past life, when we see it in the past life, we can let it go, because they no longer need it at this moment. When they see it, they understand they don't need it. Then we can find the connection with other people, because we meet each other over and over and over, and we've all been together before. So some people, when they want to know more about their relationships, for example, why they feel so drawn to another person, or maybe why they feel so challenged with another person, a past life may explain it if it is the causes in a past life. For example, maybe a wife and a husband, they've been together before. Maybe they've done lots of things together and that's why their connection is so strong. Or maybe somebody who a person is having problems with, it was an enemy in a past life, so they had a lot of clashes, and that explains things. But ultimately what they always say is that forgiveness is the main lesson. So we come here to learn, to evolve, to grow, and every spirit wants to grow. So the better we deal with our lessons on planet Earth here, the quicker we're gonna pass that. You know, it's like a graduation process, and we're all here students, helping each other. So the second part of quantum healing is contacting the subconscious of the person. And by subconscious, we mean this great power that exists in every person and outside of them. It's like the higher self, it's like the universal mind. It's the knowledge of all that there is. And when the person is deep enough, when they are relaxed, we can access that power. This is what Dolores found in quantum healing. So through the person, we access the power of the subconscious and we ask them the questions that the person has. For example, we ask them for guidance, we ask them for healing, and then magic happens. Then we receive really powerful information. Sometimes people get answers about their purpose, what they're supposed to do in life, why did they come here. Sometimes they get guidance on everyday level, how to be happier, how to be more peaceful, how to heal themselves better. And the main part is the healing, because the subconscious knows all the systems in the body. It is aware of why things happen in our body, how it is connected to our emotions, and then it can heal if it agrees during the session. It can arrange the energies and send healing energy through the body, so we can let it go. And interestingly, it can explain why the person has an ailment of some kind. For example, if they have, for example, a stomach problem, it may say that, oh, this person is having a difficulty digesting some life situations. Maybe they're going through some challenging times, so they need to try and be more relaxed. That's the advice they always give. Be more relaxed, spend more time in nature, listen more to themselves. Sometimes people may have a headache or a problem, you know, on this level, and the subconscious may say, this is all the deep thinking and all the hectic thinking that the person might have. So they might cleanse the energy, and then they give advice on how a person can deal with it. But the main thing is, I just want to say that this power is so strong, and this power is available to everybody. And even if you just ask, and you just spend a moment connecting to yourself and asking this power to talk to you and give you guidance, they will. They always say, we are with you. You're not alone. We're always with you. Just listen to yourself, be relaxed, and trust. That's their most powerful messages.
Wow. Thank you for sharing that. So there's different parts of our body. I've read somewhere that a lot of the illnesses these days, like you said, are subconscious. Parts of ourselves that need healing and that have like blocked energy. And for example, when people have, you know, diseases or like say cancer or, you know, something like this, mm-hmm. it's the body's way of communicating to them that, mm-hmm. you know, it's a last ditch attempt to say, hey, wake up, you know. Can you talk a bit more about that?
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. That's what I learned from quantum healing, because every time we ask the subconscious the reason for an illness, they can give an explanation and it gives us a very good picture. Everything is connected. So our emotions, our thoughts, our life experiences are connected with our body. So if we experience lots of heavier energies, for example, if we experience lots of stress, they say this is the main cause for illnesses. Fear, stress, and any kind of dense energies that we have in our life at the moment. So the first thing they always say is to relax, because the energy needs to flow free through the body. So if it doesn't flow free, then it can become condensed or trapped in any part of the body and in the corresponding organ. So it's very easy to understand why the ailment is coming in most of the cases, because it corresponds with what this organ means. So for example, the head. The head means thinking. Head means what's going on in our mind. So if we have problems with the head, we need to look at the way we think. For example, the eyes mean seeing, what we see in life, how we look. If we experience problems with the eyes, we can ask our eyes, are they ready to see things? Are they seeing enough? Am I okay with seeing things in my life? So maybe there's something we don't want to see. This is just a general description. Throat, communication, how we communicate with the world, how we express our truth. Heart, love. Stomach, digestion. Legs, walking. How well we walk with in life. You know, how we reach our purpose, if we move in life enough. So all these things, the best way is to actually talk to your organ. So if you experience any problem, let's just have an example. In the heart, you can connect, you can place your hands on that organ, close your eyes, breathe deeply, spend some moment to connect. You may even visualize that organ or feel the energy of that organ. And then just start receiving communication. Imagine that you're asking this organ for guidance. For example, my heart, how are you feeling at this moment? What is happening with you? Are you feeling good? Or do you need any help? What is your problem connected with in my life? Are you trying to show me anything? And then just receive all the messages that come to you. They can come as images, as a sensation, as an inner knowing, but really, really trust, because the body loves communicating. The body loves to talk, and the body is like our best friend. It needs our time, it needs some quality time, to be honest, when we are relaxed, when we give us appreciation, we love our body, and the body wants to talk. We don't give enough chance to our physical body to talk, but if we sit in silence and we ask it, it will tell us, because every illness is just a message, it's just a signal. So we don't have to go that far. We don't have to wait until something shows up in the body. We can talk a little bit before and try to arrange a situation, try to fix the situation. Maybe there is something toxic in our life. Maybe there is a relationship which is not working. Maybe there is a job which is poisoning you. We don't know. We need to ask the body and see what the body tells us. And all wisdom is inside.
Mm-hmm. So how would someone connect with that if someone's very disconnected with their body and doesn't know how to receive those messages? I mean, mm-hmm. how would they better connect with that?
Okay, I think many different ways. First of all, doing something physical with the body, maybe dancing, maybe doing yoga, doing something where you get this connection, where you get the movement. Because many times we don't do that enough. We sit a lot, you know, we have this type of lifestyle. Secondly, meditation is very important. When we meditate, we can then go deeper enough into ourselves. We can visualize things. We can place a powerful healing intention. We can talk to our body. Just saying nice things to the body is very powerful, because the body loves hearing nice things about itself. Just saying loving things. I love you so much. You're such a beautiful body. You're working so well. I trust you and believe in you. And every cell will hear that. And this is a very powerful exercise, as simple as it sounds. It's strong. Then you can write. You can channel information from your body. Take a piece of paper, feel the problem or the energy that you want to focus on in your life, and just write down intuitively everything that comes, for example, from that organ. You'll be surprised about the things that come through. So many different ways. Always listen to intuition, what your intuition tells you. Maybe you need to take a bath and just connect through water with your body. You know, maybe it's an energy work that you need to do. Okay. The body will tell you.
So I hear a few different common threads in that. It mm-hmm. seems like water is a way that, you know, absorbs that energy, and that mm-hmm. I don't know, a lot of people out there have kind of studied water and its effect and has that quality of memory. Can you talk a bit more about maybe how water plays into that?
Yes, I personally love water, just the sound of it, the idea of it. Water is everything. Water is us. We're made of water. Water is here. We're standing next to water. Water is in every plant, in every living being. It's the essence. It's like the blood of the universe. Water is beautiful. Water is alive. Water is healing. Water can hear us. Water can talk to us. We can talk to water. We can program water. We can change the way water is by what we say, what we give, what music we play to the water. If we say loving things, I love you, water, you're beautiful, you're healing, then the crystals in the water will change, because it's a living organism, it's a consciousness. I remember, I will share it now, I remember once I did a channeling, a spontaneous channeling with a friend of mine, and a very powerful information came about the water. They said that we can work on the water regardless of where we are. Even if we take a little bowl of water, we fill it in, and then we start giving love, giving healing to it, and we imagine that we give healing to all the oceans in the universe, all the seas, all the sea creatures, we can help lift up the energy of the whole water. So it says that it doesn't matter where the water is, all the water is connected. And of course, our body is water. So just knowing that, we can give love and healing to our body, and we will start feeling better as well. So everything is so linked, and I think it's very important for us to understand and feel how connected we all are. It's incredible. We love you, water.
So is it also very important to be present with the water? Because, you know, people can start talking to it, but it might, their mind might be somewhere else. They might be thinking something else at the same time. And having that presence, that awareness, that's why a lot of this mindfulness, eating, mindfulness, you know, meditation is out. Maybe talk a bit more about how awareness plays with the intention and how that amplifies it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, yes. I feel it's important to trust. I think that's what some of us are missing at the moment. The belief that everything is alive and that when we work on it, it works. Because the mind can play tricks and the mind can say, oh, are you really doing the right thing or is it really working? Just don't pay any attention to this. Mm. It's going to lead us nowhere. All we need to do is to believe and listen to intuition. So if your intuition tells you, go and bathe in the water and feel that the energy is running through your body, you can do that. Listening and trusting, I feel that's the most important thing. And all the rest, maybe it doesn't matter that much.
Wow. So life is actually way more simple than we actually think it to be. A lot of people, oh wow, it's so complicated with all this medicine and all this stuff. That has its place. But I think, like you said, just simply talking to it, I think there must have been a generation or many generations where we just forgot how to talk to our bodies, how to listen correctly, and we're so distracted with all these, you know, technology, which is great, but learning to connect with ourselves and, you know, our intuition, everything is there for us. So you said something about trees, and you can read the energy of trees. That's very, very interesting, because, I mean, every living being has a certain level of consciousness, and you can access that energy. So let's talk a bit more about that.
My favorite subject. First of all, everybody can read energies. It's not just me, it's everybody's gift. We just need to trust it and practice it, believe in it. So our hands, they have very strong energy. Mm-hmm. They have those circles of light coming off the hands. You can look at your hands now and you can imagine that you see those circles of light and they will appear. This is when we connect to the energy, for example, of another person. We can pick up this energy, we can feel what the energy is like. When we touch an object, for example, we touch the wall, the stone, or we touch the plant, the tree, we can pick up this energy as well. So through the hands, you can connect to the world and receive messages about the world. I found it through Reiki. So after practicing Reiki for some time, I felt a very strong yearning to touch things, to touch hands of people, to give messages energy-wise, to touch the trees, to touch the walls, the old walls, to connect to the history of places. And it was incredible to find out what comes through that connection. And it's true, we can read things. So talking about the trees, totally different subject. The trees are beautiful, the trees are wonderful, the trees are volunteers of light on this planet. Through trees we learn, through trees we can ascend. We can come back to the simplicity of life. We can come back to simple joy, simple tranquility, simple power. Go away from thinking. You know, every time you're in nature, some magic happens and all of a sudden you don't have to think so much, or you don't have to worry so much. Mm. It's the trees, yeah. It's the earth. And then we can talk to the trees. The trees are alive. The trees are like our friends. Every tree has a personality. We can come to the tree, we can give it a hug. Or we can just look at it. If you feel shy, you can just look at the tree or direct your hands towards the tree. There will be an energy current passing through you and the tree. And just listen. Just allow this energy to be absorbed by your energy field. And allow anything that you no longer need to go into the ground, to safely be let go. And the tree will talk through the heart, through the vibration. Maybe you'll start feeling very inspired. Maybe you'll start feeling empowered. Maybe you'll feel a feminine energy, maybe a masculine energy, maybe a child-like energy, very joyful. Every tree has something to tell us. And you can choose your friend, a tree, create a friend, and come and visit it every day. And many people tell me, Maria, but how can I hug the tree in the street? People will look at me as I'm crazy. don't worry, people need it, people would love it. They will actually admire you for doing it, and they will maybe go and do it themselves later on, so we can help each other by connecting to the trees. And the hands, I just want to mention the hands, how powerful it is. Just touch things around, touch the energy of things, and feel what's coming through the hands. It's so much more powerful than the mind, than the technical part of the mind when we read things and trying to comprehend. Through hands, we can read energy, we can read the truth. You can take another person by the hand, you can connect to the energy, and you will receive very deep, very truthful messages about their powers, about their gifts, maybe some guidance and inspiration. That's what I do when I do energy readings. It's a really, really beautiful process. And then you can also channel healing energy to another person. It's really fascinating.
Well, thank you so much, Maria, for sharing all this amazing knowledge about, we went into Reiki healing, we went into quantum healing hypnosis, and then you were talking about some past life regression and the benefits of that and some of the lessons we can learn. And then Maria was talking about some of the how to tap into the power of the hands, the power of water, and how we can connect with it, how we can talk to our organs and get the messages that our body's trying to communicate to us, heal ourselves and become more holistic and live in our true power and discover everything. So I want to thank you for all this amazing knowledge that
thank you. You can do it. You are the power.
So tell us a bit more about your workshops, and I think people can find that on your website. And tell us a bit more about your services and how can, you know, if people want to connect with you and get some readings and things like that, how they can do that.
So yes, you can go on the website, mariasuniverse.com. You can have a look at different articles. We have a YouTube channel with videos, a lot of information there. Personal sessions, so quantum healing, hypnosis, past life regressions. I do energy readings, so I read hands. So connect to the energy of your spirit and give guidance and healing as well through the hands. And also teach how to work with energy. Personally and in a group. Every Tuesday we meet in a lovely church space near Gloucester Road, in St. Stephen's Church. It's a beautiful space and we have a lovely group. Very bright souls come, so you're very welcome to come and join. We will learn to play with the energy in our hands to create beautiful objects with our hands. You will find lots of miracles and it's a joy. So thank you so much. You're welcome to ask questions or do whatever feels right.
Great. Thank you, Maria. And again, thanks for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe and reach out to Maria. And make sure you subscribe to the channel here. Like the video and share with your friends and family. Comment below if you have any questions at all, and we'll get back to you. So have a fantastic day.
Thank you. Thank you. We love you.